Mini episode 1357 of the FDH Lounge is brought to you by Sportsology, delivering unconventional columns and webcasts about sports, TV, music, movies, and more. Follow them on the web at sportsology.com.
The FDH Lounge. You want to schedule your life around it.
A long time ago, on a gloomy, wet Cleveland spring night, two men stand alone amidst the late night drizzle. Their voices echo across the vacant station parking lot as they debate the merits of the great American radio show that have been missing for far too long. On that night, an idea was born. That idea became the FDH Lounge. Welcome to the FDH Lounge.
Hello and welcome to FDH Lounge Mini Episode 1357, our 2021 NBA Draft Preview. I'm FDH Managing Partner Rick Morris here with our top five notes of interest for this fascinating draft class. Number five, coming off of a 2020 NBA draft that exceeded its low projections, the star power at the top of the 2021 NBA draft is all the more exhilarating. Jumbo-sized Oklahoma State point guard Cade Cunningham and state-of-the-art big man Evan Mobley from USC could be the best 1-2 punch at the top since Greg Oden, remember him, and Kevin Durant in 2007. From there, the two Jaylens, Suggs, point guard from Gonzaga, and Green, shooting guard from G League Ignite, bring their own brands of explosive talent to the next two teams in the lottery. Green's teammate from last season, forward Jonathan Kuminga, has incredible athleticism, if perhaps some questions about the present state of his offensive game, and then many, many questions ensue for the players to come. Number four. For most of the players on the next level below, as well as all of the rest, obviously, the majority of uncertainty comes down to the capacity to fit offensively in the modern NBA. To the extent that there is a consensus number six overall pick, it would be Florida State forward Scotty Barnes, and on this next level down, there are three swing men on the list, Tennessee's Keon Johnson, Gonzaga's Corey Kispert, and Stanford's Zaire Williams. Other players include UConn shooting guard James Booknight, Arkansas shooting guard Moses Moody, Baylor point guard Davion Mitchell, Duke small forward Jalen Johnson, Texas center Kai Jones, Michigan forward Franz Wagner, Illinois guard Io Dosunmu, and point guard Josh Giddey from Australia. Number three, teams picking in the top four who have reason to think that they have a sure thing should be encouraged by two of this year's conference finalists. Phoenix, with Devin Booker and DeAndre Ayton, began a very rapid trajectory upward, first in the Orlando bubble and then going to another level with the acquisition of CP3. Similarly, Trae Young and John Collins helped Atlanta to advance very quickly this past season. If Detroit, Houston, Cleveland, and Toronto are each able to add a franchise player to their core, then the process of rebuilding is done, and the quest for contention should begin over the next year. Number two, teams picking outside the top four should be encouraged by two of last year's conference finalists. As we covered in FDH Lounge Mini Episode 1309, we are in a golden age of player development in the NBA, where San Antonio served as a precursor and remains a shining example. But Denver and Miami making the 2020 conference finals without any highly drafted bonus babies on their rosters really opened a lot of eyes. There are many, many talents in this draft who can become stars or perhaps even superstars if they make the kind of improvements that we just can't forecast for them right now. Number one, for teams outside the top four, the siren song of tanking for 2022 and 2023 remains. Next year's draft is anticipated to be strong, at least at the top, and with 2023 likely serving as the last one with the college one-and-dones, the crop projects as uncommonly deep. Teams like Oklahoma City and Minnesota didn't find their magic bullet in this draft, although, on a side note, why Minnesota still needs additional magic bullets when they've been wasting the careers of top talents for over a decade is a mystery. But the future, as always, seems bright if you squint just hard enough. Let the tanking continue.